In a gesture of goodwill, General Muhoozi Kainerugaba donated 10 cows to Sabasajja Kabaka Muwenda Mutebi II through his delegation of PLU led by the chairperson Nuwagira Michael Kaguta, also known as Toyota. The delegation included PLU Secretary General Daudi Kabanda, Michael Katungi, PLU Director of External Affairs, Minister Balam Karugahara, several MPs and other PLU supporters. Toyota commended the Buganda Kingdom for their consistent hospitality towards the PLU and conveyed Kainerugaba's gratitude.
Asima uwa kabaka, uwe kwa tagana, uwe kwa katilienga yu sekurite, kila sekurite akwala na abantu. Kila asima uwa kwa tagana, kusekurite uwa kabaka, nungi.
Owekitiwa Anthony Wamala, representing the Katikkiro, expressed the kingdom's appreciation for the PLU's efforts to unite Ugandans across different political and religious backgrounds. He also assured the delegation of the kingdom's readiness to cooperate with the PLU. The Minister for Communication in the Buganda Kingdom likened PLU and Kainerugaba to a biblical son who understood his parents' needs and thus received his brother's blessings. The first Deputy Prime Minister and Minister for East African Affairs, Rebecca Alitwala Kadaga, met with artists from Busoga region under the Busoga Talent and Musician Network at her office in Kampala. Kadaga launched the umbrella organization for these artists and presided over the swearing-in of its leaders. Led by Helen Namutamba, the Minister for Tourism and Heritage in Busoga Kingdom, the artists asked Kadaga to be a patron for their newly formed organization. Joseph Mzali, the chairperson of the organization, thanked Kadaga for her contribution to developing the Busoga region.
If you are a musician, it's not going to be able to do it.
Kadaga also donated a computer to the organization and promised to give them SACCO funds as well as front their issues to President Yoweri Museveni for further assistance.
On saying it is a very proud Busoga. Ninda ino Busoga, ninda anything Busoga. Chibati number one. Request quite by coincidence, which did not quite meet the president. So, already I think about each one is a list young able to be a coherent.
Kadaga is an advocate for the growth and development in Busoga and has been a pivotal figure in promoting Busoga affairs, especially in the area of tourism and culture. The British Foreign Office has issued urgent warning to UK travellers, urging them to leave immediately if they are in Lebanon. This comes at a time when diplomats are racing to contain an escalation between Israel and Hezbollah. Government officials are also urging people not to travel there if they are planning on it. If they go against current advice, they say that the travel insurance could be invalidated. The British Foreign Secretary, David Lammy, warned that the events are fast moving and that the British nationals are advised to leave Lebanon and not to travel in that country.
Advise against all travel to the north of Israel and the north of the Golan Heights, and against all travel to Lebanon. There are frequent artillery exchanges and airstrikes. Tensions are high and the situation could deteriorate rapidly. But if this conflict escalates, the government cannot guarantee we'll be able to evacuate everyone immediately. People may be forced to shelter in place. And history teaches us that in a crisis like this one, it is far safer to leave while commercial flights are still running, rather than running the risk of becoming trapped in a war zone. My message then to British nationals in Lebanon is therefore quite simple. Leave.
Two barrages of rockets fired from Lebanon have killed one Israeli civilian in kibbutz and injured another person, in attacks likely to add political pressure inside Israel, a strong strike against Hezbollah, and complicate a US-led push to de-escalate the regional tensions.
The government is unequivocal in condemning this horrific attack and calling on Hezbollah to cease their rocket strikes. This atrocity is a consequence of indiscriminate firing, paying no heed at all to civilian life.
America has been leading a global diplomatic effort to deter Israel from hitting Beirut or Lebanese infrastructure in retaliation for a weekend rocket attack on the occupied Golan Heights, which killed 12 children as they played football match.